kept skating shoes for 3 weeks after the first impressions, and this is my full review on the New Balance Tiago 1010. Spending all my time and money making these videos is what I love to do, and luckily we have a sponsor. It's not sponsored. So thank you everybody who sold out over half the sizes, so I'll leave that in the top link of the description. And because this video is sponsored by myself and you guys are so supportive, I bought these shoes myself for $110, giving me the free range to talk all the poopies as I want to. Along with that high price tag, New Balance incorporated a lot of hot features in Tiago's new shoe. They come with fuel cell foam, a lace closure that ensures a secure fit, suede and mesh upper for comfort and style. Upper features a no-sew overlay for a sleek fit and feel. 90s inspired style with a cutting edge design to create a go-to shoe for skating. Let me go ahead and break these features down for you really quick. Whatever a fuel cell isn't gonna make you run any faster, and as long as these laces don't rip, your foot will be secure. And a cup sole is always good for me. And any New Balance shoe that you skate is usually pretty comfortable. And as far as them saying that this shoe is sleek, I actually feel like they're kind of bulky. So far, any New Balance shoe that I skate is extremely comfortable, and these are no exception. It feels like I got two little pillows hugging my feet, and I love it. I do appreciate these Zonopods, I think that's how you pronounce it. That's in the back of the heel because it feels like it holds your Achilles and it's really nice. I had really high hopes that these shoes would make me skate like Tiago, and there must be some type of magic in them because my switchback tails felt amazing. Okay, but seriously, I felt like these shoes gave me a pretty good confidence level, and all of that extra padding really helped. Any kickflip that I did with these shoes felt fantastic. Even after 3 weeks, the flick felt consistent throughout the entire duration of me skating these shoes. Even after skating these shoes for 3 weeks, I feel like the outsole is still really stiff, and I don't feel like it's gonna loosen up anytime soon. The tread on these shoes held up as I expected them to, and it's just now starting to wear down on the balls of my feet. But I don't think I'm gonna start to wear down that fuel cell anytime soon. When it came to the impact protection on these shoes, I did feel comfortable jumping down an average size set of stairs, but I didn't really want to jump down anything that big. Overall though, the impact protection on these is pretty good. The supposed laces that are supposed to ensure secure fit ripped at the top of the shoe, and I'm not really surprised because that eyelet is in a really bad place. The one eyelet at the top of the shoe is directly in the line of contact when I do my heel flips. And not to mention, this yellow eyelet that holds one of the laces is starting to fall off completely. So what the hell, New Balance? Fix your laces.
This thing rips off. This yellow piece. They thought I wouldn't know.
As far as these shoes looking like an old man's shoe or a young guy's shoe, I feel like any white New Balance shoe with the N logo on the side of it is gonna look like a dad shoe. Aside from the lace and eyelets ripping, these shoes are pretty durable because the rest of the shoe is holding up really well. And if I wasn't gonna move on to another shoe, I could probably skate these shoes for another couple of weeks. The fuel cell in the heel of the shoe definitely helped my heel from getting heel bruise, but I did feel like I had to put some insoles in here to protect the balls of my feet. These are a highly detailed and high performance skate shoe in my eyes. When it comes to buying these shoes, you should get them if you're serious about your skateboard. With that being said, if you can afford to get a shoe that's $110 that you're gonna be skating for a little while, then I would say it's worth it. Honestly, if I wasn't doing these shoe reviews for you guys, then I probably wouldn't have gotten these shoes because they're really just not my style. And if you wanna see the trials and tribulations of me skating these shoes, then the past 3 weekend sessions on my channel is all about skating these, having fun with my friends. So, leave a comment down below, let me know what shoes you want to review next, what boys you want to review next, what spots you want to see on the weekend sessions, and we are on the road to 2 million! It's awesome! We're at 40,000, thank you again for that, that's great. And speaking of moving on to new shoes, I gotta move on from these, so you know what's gonna happen, I'm about to... Let's do something different. I'm done with these shoes. Shoe drop! Congratulations, you. Yep, you. You. You beautiful ass person. You're here still. That's great. That's fantastic. You're the guy. You're the guy that's my homie guy. What's up, guy? Hey, you wanna give me nucks, guy? Hit the screen. Here's the thing, okay? In 2 years, I'm going to have to either stop doing YouTube videos or I have achieved everything I wanted. So, I hope that this brand inspires you to do as much shit as you can. Because honestly, I'm doing everything I'm doing right now because I know I would just die with regret of not trying. So that's what I'm doing. So anything that you think you would just die with regret without trying, please try it. At least for a little bit. Then you could for sure say, oh, that's just not, I tried. You know, because at the end of the day, that's all you can do. All you can do is just try your best. I love you guys. I hope that you guys have a good day. I hope you guys go skate something fun. I hope y'all learn a new trick. And I hope you have that fantastic love and joy in your heart when you land something that you're just like, that was great. Okay, I love you guys. Bye.